Thank you. LaBarr is called Now Touch the Air Softly. It's based on a poem by William J. Smith, and he lived to be 98 years old. And so I figure somebody who lives to be 98 years old and can write the kind of text and lyrics that he does really knows something. It's all about love, and it's very whimsical. It's like, I will love you forever till bread is like gravel, and till roses are lavender, and lavender's red, and all of this. It's a very beautiful, whimsical, dreamy kind of text. We hope you enjoy. Now touch the air softly.
Thank you.
Johnson is not Christy Livingston, who is normally our stalwart accompanist, and unfortunately, a couple of weeks ago, she needed to step down to tend to a family situation, and Lucy bravely stepped up with just a week or two to learn all of this music. So, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. These spring concerts that I'll be directing, and she came up with a theme, There Is Sweet Music, and she allowed me to pick whatever music I wanted, which was very gracious of her. And this piece that we just sang for you, Sing to Me, it's, to me, it's just this very beautiful, tender beginning of spring. And it's acknowledging that spring is coming, even though there is winter all around us, and especially last night, and our Telluride singers, they know there was winter all around us on their drive down yesterday. So I'm glad the sun is shining a little bit today and we could start feeling that a little bit more. In the same vein, this next piece that we're gonna sing for you called There Is Sweet Music by Daniel Gawthrop. I couldn't turn this piece down just because it's the same title as the title of our concert, so I just had to do it. And today we're singing this piece in memory of Yasuko Matsumoto, who is a friend of the Durango Choral Society. She passed away on February 13th in Tokyo at the age of 98, surrounded by her devoted family. May this music lie gently on her spirit.
Roses on the grass.
all-time favorite composers. His name is Morten Lauridsen, a very famous, prolific contemporary choral composer. He's an older gentleman, and he's a professor emeritus at this point at the University of Southern California in Thornton. But he actually spends a lot of his time living up on Waldron Island, which is off of the north coast of the state of Washington. It might be in the San Juan Islands, I'm not certain, but he has a house up there. And when he composes music, it's often at this home. And so what he is hearing, as he says, he's in the company of seagulls, eagles, and lapping waves. So in this piece, you're going to hear the movement of the water in the piano part and in the voices with the tempo. It's very rubato, very free-flowing. And this text is in French, Dirait-On. It's by a poem by Rainer Maria Rilke. And it essentially speaks of tenderness and love. And so we can focus on that. And it, and again, typifies this sweetness of the of this new spring that's upon us.
Qui sont ces
the Hebrides Islands, and mouth music, from its inception, Celtic mouth music was a music meant to fill the gaps created by poverty, religious oppression, and or a lack of good instrumentalists, but mostly the latter. It's vocal music that's meant for dancing, in which the singers imitate the music of fiddles, bagpipes, and jews' harps. And it's what they say, it's full of word wizardry that creates its own complex rhythms. So as you're listening to this piece today, you'll hear some words that are recognizable, and then you'll hear a lot of what we call our vocables. They're nonsense syllables, but they're meant to depict the sound of these musical instruments when people just didn't simply have any. So in order to make this music even more authentic, we've invited our friend today, Bob Condon from the Kitchen Jam Band. And he will be playing the Bowron. I hope I pronounced that correctly. Okay. Docile, or being quiet, or being mute. It's about just the opposite. It's about standing up, speaking the truth, and waking up. And sometimes, when we need to wake up, we need a really loud alarm clock, like the gentle little chime isn't going to do it for us. We need something that's more powerful. This piece is really dissonant, it's strong, it's uncomfortable in a lot of ways, but the message is important. And in your programs, you actually have the text of this piece, which is written by Joyce Sidman, this poem, Starting Now. And feel free to look at it, or not, while you're listening to this, but you get to take it home with you because I think the text is so important about what it's saying. We hope you enjoy starting now.
Thank you.
program and from word of mouth around town, we have some very special guests today, members of the Telluride Choral Society. The last time that they were able to come up here and travel and collaborate in one of our March concerts was exactly 3 years ago this week, in March of 2020. And we all know what happened the week after that, right? And at that time in March of 2020, I was currently the director of the Telluride Choral Society. I had been the director for about 10 years. We came up here, we had great concerts with Linda and the groups up here, and then we went home, and then the whole world shut down. And a few months later, my husband and I decided to move here to Durango. We have a daughter that lives here, and we were looking forward to a new chapter in our lives, but sadly, I had to leave some really, really good friends behind in the Telluride Choral Society, friends of 20, 25 years. And we agreed, fortunately they have a new wonderful director, Mr. Hal Adler, who you'll see in just a moment. And they have carried on, and I'm so thrilled about that. And we've kind of waited this period of time through the pandemic, navigating our way through it. And this is the moment to welcome them back to Durango. And I have to say that as they started coming in the door yesterday for our sound check in the afternoon, I felt like this little piece of my heart that had been left up in Telluride for the last 3 years started coming in the door, and it just kind of fit right into my heart here. And now to have my Telluride Choral Society family and my Durango Choral Society family reunited, it's like my heart is just bursting. It's just so wonderful. So without further ado, they have a wonderful program that you're gonna love. I'd like to introduce, under the direction of Hal Adler, the Telluride Choral Society.
Sing a song, let harmony be true. Come join the crowd, sing long and loud like good chordbusters do.
Let's bust a chord,
a good old major chord.
Some ringing harmony.
Come on and
join the fun, we'll bust a minor one as we warble merrily.
Diddy bum bum bum.
Let's sing it through again and then we'll all chime in. It will make your heart feel light.
You'll be
hoarse tomorrow, but forget your sorrow while we bust a chord tonight.
Bust a chord tonight if you're a low-down bass. Come on and find your place.
And a tenor will be welcome, never fear.
If you're a baritone, and a lead is what we need right over here.
Over here. Chord or two, and then you'll know it's true. That a song makes things go right. Weigh your trouble, let your joy be double while we bust a chord tonight. While we bust a chord tonight.
Rhonda and the Durango Singers for inviting us and sharing this stage, and it's so lovely to be reconnected to this long-standing, wonderful tradition of having these communities come together in song. It is just wonderful to be back here. Thank you so much for your hospitality and for allowing us to share this stage. We've got two more. The first is Versus Light of a Clear Blue Morning. You might know this song if you are an old Dolly Parton fan. You might know this song if you are a Waylon Jennings fan. Waylon Jennings adapted it and sang it in an a cappella version. The Dolly Parton version is a bit of a pop version. The Waylon Jennings is a really quite a beautiful a cappella, slower paced. And we have pretty close to the Waylon Jennings version. Dalen Stevens has transcribed it for us for choir, so we're very happy to bring you that song today. And then the third and last is the Ubi Caritas. This is Duruflé's particular composition of Ubi Caritas. And as much as anything else, the Ubi Caritas is a prayer for peace. The Light of a Clear Blue Morning is a song about transformation and about self-empowerment and unlocking oneself from the struggles and the pressures and the binds of what might be holding us back. So glad to be here, and thank you again.
See you.
This abundance of nature, and we really need it, and may the Telluride singers get back really safely and drive really slowly back over the pass. But this is all about the beginning of spring and the flowers peeping out their heads. It's a really joyful song. We hope you enjoy it. And today we have soloist Lars Hansen.
Grass.
light of a clear blue morning. They also have a really wonderful arrangement of Parting Glass that if you happen to be fortunate enough to go to their concert up at Fort Lewis College back in the fall, they finished the concert with this beautiful, sweet a cappella arrangement of Parting Glass. It's really an old Scottish-Irish tune, and it's meant to pay homage to people that have passed, to wish them well, and all within this vein of all of us just rising up, all of us rising up, and the sweetness of remembering somebody that's passed. This piece, we're singing this piece today for a really dear friend of ours, Stu Fraser, who passed away last year. A good friend to all of us, his wife Ginny is here, and he was a good friend, one who brought union to people. He was a good public servant. He was a town councilman and the mayor of Telluride for quite a number of years. He was very active on the board of the Telluride Choral Society and also served as president of the board for a number of years. And he was, for me, a beloved fixture in the bass section along with my husband, Peter, where they would cut up and get into trouble in rehearsals. And we're singing this song today in honor of Stu. He captivated many people in Telluride and also many people here in Durango. So this is our way of honoring him, joining our voices in song together to honor and remember our dear friend, Stu. Eileen Burns will sing the opening solo, and Dalen Stevens is the one who arranged this this version of Parting Glass. We hope you feel the sweetness of this in your heart, and may Stu hear it wherever he is.
Of all the money that e'er I spent it all in good company.
Oh.
lots of talented, dedicated, intelligent people, good friends. And so I like to always do my thank yous before the final piece of the concert. Our season sponsor is TBK Bank, so thank you. If there are any of you out in the audience, thank you so much. And if you're not, may you hear my words of gratitude. Thank you to TBK Bank. And today's concert sponsor is Linda Mack Bourbon, our fearless artistic director on sabbatical in California right now, and her husband, Wynn Bourbon. Thank you, Linda and Wynn. We have a really fine board of directors here, headed up by our president, Abby Bowen, up in the alto section. Our vice president, Bill Thurman, who puts together the Riser Group. And our executive director, Dawn Spader, who just kind of manages everything behind the scenes. So grateful to our board of directors for really putting together. I want to thank Lucy Johnson one more time. Thank you to the folks at Summit Church for allowing us to perform in this beautiful consecrated space. It's really a delight to be here. The acoustics are primo, and for me, it's close to home. I just live two blocks up the road. And I want to thank all of our donors and granting organizations. They're listed in your program. And should you want to see your name as one of those fabulous people, that can be arranged, so see me after the concert. Also, if you're one of those people that's just like, you really like to sing and you've got a little bit of experience, come see me, because we're always looking for new members. So I want to just invite you to come be a part of the Choral Society. I want to thank the Telluride Choral Society singers under the direction of Hal Adler for making the trip. And I want to thank, of course, Durango Women's Choir, Durango Choral Society. I could not ask for a better group of musicians to work with from the bottom of my heart. Could not ask for that. It's like, so thrilled. We came through a really interesting season. We were supposed to have 7 weeks of rehearsal. We had about five. We had snowstorms, we had COVID, we had all kinds of things going on, new accompanists. And I'm so thrilled that we made it here well and able to celebrate with all of you. And so final thank you to you, the audience, for turning out today. It means everything to us, your support today. And so here is our final piece, The Storm is Passing Over. If you feel like clapping or dancing at any point, feel free. We've got lots of space.
To God, the morning.
concert, April 28th, Friday night. Be here or be square, CNN. Okay, thank you.